was like, oh my gosh, if I had not put her in here this morning, she would have gone down to the pasture or the woods and had these babies I would have never known. Good morning, guys. Welcome back to Blue Ridge Farmstead. My name is Stephanie, and today we're out in the greenhouse. We're going to be transplanting some of our little basil seedling starts into some larger containers. For some reason, these this year I haven't had as good a luck with basil as I did last year. And I'm not sure why. I don't know if it's the mix that I started with. We're going to be transplanting these little seedling starts into some larger containers, single containers, see if they can do better. If not, I have quite a bit of basil started. I just hate to give up on seedlings. I just hate. I know that people go through with little scissors and they prune out seedlings that look weak or seedlings, and it just breaks my heart to do that. I think, oh, so that could be someone's food, or that could be the best one out of the whole bunch, and there I am snipping it off. And so I just can't do that right now. If they die, they die, and then I'll toss them out, but I'm not going to give up on them just yet. So I have four. You can see how they just look weak and pitiful. But, oh, they smell wonderful. This is organic sweet basil. Four little organic sweet basil starts. And while we're doing that, I'm going to catch you guys up on what's been going on here at the farm. We now have turned into goat farmers. We didn't realize that's the direction we were headed, but that's where we're at. So we got, so I'll just back up a couple of years ago. Well, I guess about 18 months ago, we reached out to a friend and neighbor, Jamie from Seven Stands Farm, to inquire about getting a couple of goats for our garden. We had a garden space in 2020. You guys can go back and look at the videos from that. Horrible. It just turned into a jungle, and we thought, well, let's go ahead and get some goats and pigs and chickens on that area to get it cleaned out and prepared for the next planting year. And that's what we did, and it turned out well. And in the process, we fell in love with our two Miatonic goats, Jimmy and Hannah. And then last year rolled around, Hannah was bred. We did not get baby goats in the summer. Then we thought we were gonna get goats in the fall, and we started having all kinds of problems with Hannah. You guys know all about that. And then she died. She died around the first of the year. And in order, well, that really kind of broke our hearts. We really liked her. And she listened. Or I guess I should say she was more tame than the replacement we got for her. So our replacement for Hannah was a Miatonic goat that we picked up in Tennessee. And we got a bred goat. She was already bred with a billy from that farm, and her name is Lucy. Okay, so Lucy was exposed in, like, I thought it was like late November to December, but apparently it was a little earlier than that, because over the last couple of weeks she's just been kind of acting a little strange. We've never had goats born here on this farm, so we didn't really know what to expect. But earlier this week, I'm sorry, late last week, she started squatting a lot. She was trying to get away from Jimmy. I found her down in the woods in the pasture, which was a little bit strange because we can't really even keep her in the pasture. And Jamie from Seven Stands told me that when goats get ready to have their babies, they try to get away from everyone else. So in order to prevent her having her babies over last weekend when it was super cold at night, I brought her into the barn on Thursday morning. And when I did that, I was just going to keep her in the barn for a few days and see what happened. And so the kids and I were out here working. We went in for lunch. We came back out 2 hours later and she had dropped one baby. Good job. Shh. Oh my goodness. She just had it. Like, oh my gosh, if I had not put her in here this morning, she would have gone down to the pasture of the woods and had these babies. I would have never known. I possibly would have never been able to socialize them. Wow. I mean, it was just like perfect timing. So when we came out, because that was her first time being bred, we were not sure if she would have one or two. We knew that sometimes goats on their first kidding would only have one baby. Or that could be a possibility. And so we watched her for a little while and we were like, oh my gosh, that looks like a foot coming out. So earlier today we brought Lucy into the barn because she just looked like she was uncomfortable. Vulva was really swollen, so it looked like she was getting ready to have her babies the next couple of days. We went into the house for a couple of hours and came back and she had already dropped one. I was cleaning it up, and then while we were out here, she had another one. Girl, the second baby was a boy, and they are beautiful. Beautiful baby goats. They're eating really well and growing really well. They look very healthy. They're very calm now to begin with. We were not really able to pick them up much. They cried a lot, but now they're a lot more used to us. So our plan for these goats, now that we have Lammy, who we thought was a lamb, but now she's a goat, Betty, who was her friend, Lucy, who's the myotonic that we picked up to replace Hannah, and Lucy's baby, who we have named Crystal, because it looks like she has a C on her back. we're going to have four does to our one buck, Jimmy. So hopefully, our plan would be towards the end of the year to remove Jimmy's apron. We're going to have to put his apron back on him. Remove Jimmy's apron and expose all the girls probably in November, so that next April we're able to hopefully have babies out of all of them. They'll all be ready next year. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how we became unexpected goat farmers in the course of about 2 weeks.
She's a new mommy. Is that one soft?
Yeah, this one's soft.
Crystal.
Christina. Can I hold her? Can I hold her, Mommy?
There you go.
Come here, baby. they blue?
Yes.
Wait. Yeah.
Look.
Look, Lammy, you have crayons.
They're actually closer to her age than...
Can I hold her again?
Betty. She's trying to drink right now.
She's so pretty.
Then I'm going to do something.
No, don't pick her back up, sweet pea.
Now that we have her, she's going to probably be...